Tremendous. I just want you guys all to congratulate yourself first. This lady's done an amazing job bringing all you guys together. I know that there's a lot of different protests going on, but you got to continue this because this is what people want. We want justice. We want to defund. But you guys mentioned, you know, well, what's next maybe, or what can we do? How do we defund? You know, how do you actually stop the enslavement that's been going on for years? And I just want to, I actually just had a meeting with a few good people, and I was telling them that there's actually some bills that have been, it's called push for further study. You know, they kind of just throw it under the rug. I don't know, but I know there's a lot of people here, but when I looked on this website, it's called 50, I think it's called Last 50. Regardless of what it's called, I'll give you the bill numbers that you guys need to be looking for and be aggressively contacting your Congress members, aggressively contacting your city representatives, your state representatives, because there's actually legislation that can actually help this enslavement. And let me give you the numbers, and I won't give you what they are, but let's give you the numbers if anybody got a pen. The first one, it's called Certificate of Teachers. It's called RI-87292. And what this does is it creates minority teachers recruitment by allowing the Commission of Education to implement strategies to reach a goal of 200 minority teachers by the year 2025. Now, that could help. Let me give you another one. There's about six of them, but I'll just... There's another one. This is a big one. This is called the Bail in Recognizance. This is RI-87143. This has also been introduced at the beginning of the year and got pushed under the rug for further review. And it won't probably hit legislation again, maybe in November if we're lucky. But these are bills that only had a review of maybe five or six people and only were sponsored by, let me give you some of the names, Karen, Bob, Jason, Camille, and Anesthesia. Now, these are your local representatives. These are people that have actually been trying to eliminate some of this enslavement, I'll call it. These people have actually looked at legislation and just threw it under the rug for further study because they don't know the community. Because the community that they're looking to represent are not speaking up. So we appreciate the people that are here, and this is well and good. And I was telling my team that we need to actually transfer this energy into the way that they actually do it. And so we want to do it our way. You know, we've been doing it the law and order way for a long time, and it seems like the energy is here now where we can protest and force the issue, but it seems like it's going to get bounced back to the same old thing, legislation. And so the only way we can change legislation is by showing up in the voter booths. The only way that we can change the rules is we got to play by their game first. So all of you guys have to, and I call this the times 10 rule with my team. Each one of you have to grab 10 people, actually nine. What I do is I grab nine. Nine people, get the name, phone number, and address, and ask them if they're registered to vote, and stay on them. And those 10 people are ordered, and their job is to get 10 people. And so if you do this, you will multiply this just like the internet. And so you don't have to worry about the distractions because you have a very set, disciplined set of plan to beat the system. This is working because we're getting the voice, but they play by their rules. And so this is how you beat them at their rules. You read their rules, you read their guidelines, you read their citations. This is how they change rules. Okay, well, if we get enough people to sponsor this, they have to bring it to Gina. Gina has to sign these into law. It's very simple, but we have to do more of reading these bills. Five people reviewing this bill. Let me give you one more, because this is a very important one. This is the expungement of records. This girl, there was a girl that talked amazing. I wish we could have brought her back up, because that was amazing. The expungement of records. The expungement of records has constantly, you know, forced people back into the society after they get released from jail, and they are are second-class citizens. There is no opportunity for housing. Someone mentioned that. There's no opportunity for insurance. Jobs won't hire people because they rather hire somebody that doesn't have a liability for the insurance company. And the company says, yes, we take everybody, but they won't because the insurance company makes the call. And so we need to be boycotting the insurance companies that have this in their statutes. The ones that are not allowing these people to get reintegrated back into society. Yes, Donald Trump, he had a little first step program. Yeah, look what he's doing now. So we need to make sure that we actually speak their language. And this is their language. I know their language. And so what I'm doing is I'm doing the times 10 rule. And I'm going to every community and just pulling up on them, just like I just did here. I wasn't looking to speak. I actually was taking this to go meet with someone that actually could help me put this in the terminology and language that needs to be put in so the presentation is solid. So everybody can speak the same language. If we speak their language, which they like to speak is Latin, so if there's any Latin scholars, I would love to speak with you. Because if we speak this language, we will make it happen. Black Lives Matter! Black Lives Matter! I love you, thank you.
Great job, miss.
Round of applause!